crowd
Generation
goes,
Next, wow. Striving to be the best. From the dugout to the end zone, to the bottom of the net. AYFL in flow league, we running like field and track. SWFYFL, South Florida is where we at. Get it poppin' and put Optimus and Pop Warner on the map. The only sports youth network to go beyond the game and back. With some of your favorite leagues, like Miami Extreme. On Sunday at 12:30, this is where you need to be. NBC 6.
Generation Next.
Welcome to Generation Next Youth Sports Network, brought to you by U18 Sports Medicine, right here on your favorite station, NBC 6 South Florida. Of course, I'm Jonah Woullard with my lovely co-host, Kimberly Bell. It's time for some football. We are getting ready for the playoff.
That's right, Jonah. But before we get there, let's talk about October, Breast Cancer Awareness Month. As I can see, you busted out your gray shirt with a little pink highlight. I wear pink each and every week in honor of these amazing women.
Yes.
So we do just want to take a moment to make sure we show them some love in this month that celebrates breast cancer awareness.
And talking about showing some love, it's time to show some love for the Heisman watch list. Who's going to be the best? Who's going to be the top of the charts? You'll find out right here on Generation Next.
That's right, Jonah. But let's kick it off talking about great parks. AYFL, PPO Bengals, Plantation Wildcats in a dead heat, 44 wins
wow.
apiece. But be sure that the Davy Broncos are bucking their way into second place. They're going to give them a run for their money.
Well, I can tell you a place where there are no ties. Let's talk about in the Florida Youth Football League. It's going down. The Ravens with a firm hold in first place. But guess what? Mm-hmm. Second place is changing over there. The winds are changing. Cat 5 is on the way. You already know. Fort Lauderdale Hurricanes in second place in the FYFL.
Did I just do that?
Yes, you did.
Let's talk NYFL, the National Youth Football League. We've been talking about them week in and week out. The Oak Grove Raiders still dominating, but as we get close to the postseason, be sure that the Opa-locka Hurricanes and the Helpingham Bulls are saying not so quick there, boys. And the Bulls having two still undefeated teams,
yes.
Their 6U and their 10U, yeah, they're vying for that first shot.
Absolutely. Now, we're going to switch gears, and I know you're excited about it, Kim, and I am too. Now, we know we love those guys over in the NYFL, but let's talk about Pop Warner action mm-hmm. is going down. Liberty City is always doing their thing on the big, big stage,
yeah.
But as a park, Wincherry Bulls representing on the big level, but guess who's coming up behind them?
Who?
Florida City Razorbacks right on their heels.
You know what? I'm glad to see these story programs in Pop Warner really dominating. I mean, there's so much heritage there. Now, let's switch gears. Miami Extreme.
Yes.
Again, two teams, two parks we've been talking about a lot this year. The South Miami Grey Ghosts, the Miramar Patriots, but hold your horses. The Kendall Colts, huge week for them, defeating the Miramar Patriots in two different pounds. Be on the lookout for the Kendall Colts.
Absolutely. And speaking of that big defeat, let's check out the action where the West Miramar Patriots, they're having homecoming, but they're facing the Kendall Colts. The Kendall Colts would not show up to the party empty-handed.
No, for sure not. They've got number 6, Ari Ortega. Woo, he's a whole bag of tricks in and of himself.
Let's check out the action.
Just in case you didn't get your youth football fixed just yet, the West Miramar Patriots were hosting the Kendall Boys and Girls Club Colts in some fantastic 12 and under action out of the Miami Extreme League. And it's Ari Arteaga getting into the end zone for the Kendall Boys and Girls Club Colts. Extra point would be converted, and it was 8-0 just like that. West Miramar Patriots looking for an answer on defense, but not finding much as the Kendall Boys and Girls Club Colts up 8-0 grind out the clock the best they can. West Miramar Patriots with not much time left in the fourth quarter on the attack, looking to do what they can to respond, but then it's picked off and the Kendall Boys and Girls Club Colts hold on, and they're your 8-0 winners.
Congratulations to the Boys and Girls Club doing a big Kendall Colts, upsetting the West Miramar Patriots. You know what? You said they would be bearing gifts, and they did, bringing the fat hot donut right to the field.
You're a mess. We've been at quite a few West Miramar Patriot homecomings. That is definitely a new item on the homecoming menu. And that's not where it stopped. The Kendall Colts actually won the 12U and 13U matchups.
Yep.
Let's check in with the MVP of this game, Ari Ortega.
My name's Ari Ortega. I play running back for the Kendall Colts. I want to shout out my mom, my coaches, my dad, and my friends. Go Colts.
Congratulations to the Kendall Colts winning big over there in Extreme Football. Now, talking about that MVP really representing, our congratulations. And speaking of MVPs, let's talk about U18 Sports Medicine, keeping you on top of your game, a division of Joe DiMaggio Hospital.
This is Dr. Jeremy Frank from U18 Sports Medicine, here today to talk to you about swelling. Swelling is a common issue in the ankle, wrist, elbow, and knee after a sports injury. If you find that your joint is swollen, the first thing you should do is stop playing the particular sport that you're involved in, rest the joint, and if you can, elevate it. You can take some ice and anti-inflammatories. If the swelling persists and doesn't go away, then it's time to seek out consultation from your sports medicine surgeon or provider. That was today's sports injury tip from U18 Sports Medicine.
Thanks so much to our family over at U18 Sports Medicine. And remember, if your child needs a sports medicine or pediatric orthopedic doctor, visit our friends at U18 Sports Medicine on their website to make an appointment, get injury prevention tips, request a coach's clinic, and much more. And when we come back, Pop Warner, AYFL, and FYFL action. And Joan and I, yeah, we're talking Heisman right here on Generation Next. It's the big game day and you have your checklist checked. You know where the bathroom is, you know where the concession stand is, and you even know where not to sit. But what if you had to save a life in an emergency? Do you know where the AED is? Communities with comprehensive AED programs that include CPR and AED training have achieved survival rates as high as 90% for cardiac arrest victims. Anytime, anywhere, be prepared to save a life. For more information, visit onebeatcpr.com or call 855-1-BEAT. One Beat CPR and AED, saving lives one heart at a time.
Dear candidate, unfortunately, you have not been accepted. You lack the right feet, turnout, torso length, and bust for ballet. And at 13, you are too old to be considered.
Welcome back to Generation Next, Youth Sports Network, straight in the game, right here on NBC 6 South Florida, brought to you by U18 Sports Medicine. Now, Jonah, 2014 been a great season so far. Yes. A lot of big games, big plays, big players.
Absolutely. Those big-time players make big-time plays in those big-time mm-hmm. games, Kim. And, of course, let's start at the top, the 14 and under, one of our favorite weight and age divisions.
That's for sure. And the haters are going to hate, but all my boys come from one team, the Miami Garden Chiefs. Let's start with the running back, Naquan Wright, no stranger to Generation yes. Next. Quarterback, Lorenzo Floyd, and, of course, their other running back, James Cook. Now, my only fear is that they're going to split votes, but, hey, it is what it is. Only one can win. How about those 13 you guys?
I can tell you on the 13U, there won't be splitting any of those votes, three different teams. Let's start over in the AYFL. PPO Bengals has a quarterback. That signal caller name is Daniel Richardson. Let me tell you, this guy does it all. Mm-hmm. He can actually see the field, scan the field, and deliver the ball and make all the throws, and then you kind of change those gears. Michael Butner over here in this team that you see behind mm-hmm. us, the pound up, of course, on that 13U. Miami Gardens Ravens doing it big, and then now let's go down to the city. Liberty City Warriors has one of the best running backs you'll see anywhere. Mr. Raekwon mm-hmm. Berry, all-star.
Now let's talk about Liberty City Warriors, Pop Warner elite, but we've got an even bigger matchup going on. The Florida City Razorbacks
yes.
taking on the Overtown Tornadoes. A couple of Heisman candidates right there.
Undefeated streak is on the mm-hmm. line here with those Florida City Razorbacks going against those Overtown Tornadoes. Let me tell you, look at your man right now, mm-hmm. Andrew Johnson, one yep. of the best running backs you'll see on the 9U division anywhere.
Been an MVP a couple of times this season alone. And, of course, we cannot forget his quarterback counterpart, Berman Livingston Jr., again, leading his season so far to an undefeated season. Lewis was there to check out all the action. Let's get right into it, Lewis.
We're hosting the Florida City Razorbacks, and there was definitely pink on everything as it's Breast Cancer Awareness Month. The Overtown Tornadoes, two-time defending champions, welcoming the Florida City Razorbacks with a 14-yard run on offense. Hello, wake up, it's game time, baby. and wake up the Florida City Razorbacks do as the Overtown Tornadoes are unable to convert before the first half ends 0-0. Second half, however, and the Overtown Tornadoes come out. It's a different story. Andrew Johnson showing you the open field speed before he's taken down by Michael Griffin. Griffin definitely saving a touchdown there. Florida City thinking they have it, but the Overtown Tornadoes hold on to it. Then it's Furman Livingston Jr. using the wide receiver screen to pick up a good 9 yards. Overtown feeling it now. Furman Livingston Jr., Warren Moon quarterback sneak. You remember the Houston Oilers play? Well, that looked just like it as he gets into the end zone. Florida City now trying to respond after being down 7-0, but not finding much as the Overtown Tornadoes feeling that victory in their clutches. And they're going to get this interception and leave with a 7-0 victory.
Well, somebody had to win and somebody had to lose. And this week, it was Overtown's week to come out victorious. They are the only undefeated 90-pound team in all of Pop Warner right now. Let's check in with Lewis as he talks to the winning team.
Work hard. Got the best coaching staff in the world. Got the best players in the world. And that's what we do. We just grind it out every day, man. Every day is a grind. Work hard.
Congratulations once again to those Overtown Tornadoes, the mini F5 boys doing it big, those 90-pounders continuing their winning streak in Miami Pop Warner.
That's right, Jay, and talk about doing it big, the FYFL, a big-time battle in the Gardens. The Miami Garden Chiefs taking on the Miami Garden Ravens, the Ravens being led by number 0, Dedrick Stanley, number 2, Brian Bruton, and, of course, number 3, Tywan Cash.
Of course. Now, Mr. Nanjay Gunther doing it big over there for the Chiefs, and also, let me tell you, Vamir Cadet, one of the top players you'll see in any youth football league.
For sure. Well, it's going down in the Gardens. Let's get into the action.
The Ravens had the ball first, and it's Edwin Rhodes III jumping in action, picking up 13 yards before he's taken down by the Chiefs. Offensive drive sputters out, so it's the Miami Gardens Chiefs going to the air. Great catch by Leonard Schultz right there. Then the Chiefs trying to do a little something to the boundary, getting it to the wide receiver bubble screen, but the Ravens get it out of bounds before it converts. Ravens now on offense, and it's Dedrick Stanley Jr. going in for the first touchdown of the day. Ravens were on top. Then it's Dedrick Stanley Jr. yet again, going back at it, going back at the defense, 17 yards, then a 23-yard touchdown run. Ravens were on top by 2 scores now. Miami Gardens Chiefs defense looking for an answer, but not finding much. Edwin Rhodes converting the extra point there. Miami Gardens Chiefs now trying to get it going on offense, but it's the Ravens defense getting it going. Defensive ends, linebackers, and everywhere. It must have been a nightmare for the Chiefs. Chiefs still fighting, though, and they get the ball on defense, trying to take a muff snap all the way to the touchdown. And then it's going to be Leonard Schultz. Beautiful catch. But at the end of the day, the Ravens and Dedrick Stanley Jr. run away with it.
Congratulations to the Miami Garden Ravens, 12 and under victorious, once again continuing their undefeated streak in the FYFL. Let's check out the winners.
My name is DJ Stanley, the game MVP of the Miami Garden Ravens, and the Ravens have been rated G.
Ravens starting to look like pros on these Generation Next cameras, definitely getting ready for the playoffs. But remember, if you stay ready, you don't have to get ready, and we want you to stay ready to save a life anytime, anywhere with our one beat CPR tip of the week.
Hi, my name is Al from One Beat CPR and AED. Why should we get certified in CPR and AED? Here's an important fact. 1 in 7 people will have the opportunity to use CPR or an AED in their lifetime. Being certified doesn't only benefit you, but everyone around you, because you never know when CPR will be needed. Statistics show you most likely you'll be using CPR or an AED to save the life of a loved one. One Beat CPR and AED has certified thousands of people right here in South Florida. We're dedicated to making the world a safer place, one heart at a time.
Thanks once again to our friends over at OneBeat CPR. And make sure you join Generation X and OneBeat for our Save a Life tour at a park near you.
That's right, Jonah. And of course, Generation X fam, when we come back, we talk more youth football Heisman. And you'll even get to see some of these Heisman candidates in our upcoming action. So grab a snack. We'll be right back. It's Generation Next. Generation Next is brought to you by U18 Sports Medicine, Joe DiMaggio Children's Hospital, the Miami Dolphins, NBC 6 South Florida, Broward Sheriff's Advisory Council, OneBeat CPR, Under Armour, the Orange Bowl, and Sun Life Stadium.
Team 6 is always on the clock, so you're always up to speed.
Every morning, we're on the scene wherever news breaks, so you don't miss a thing.
Live in Doral.
Live in Margate.
I've got my eye on live First Alert Doppler to keep you ahead of severe weather.
And I'll get you around trouble spots so you can make it to where you need to be on time.
Then it's our job to get you caught up.
The moment you wake up.
Good morning, I'm DeJuan.
Watch NBC 6 South Florida today on air or stream us live weekdays from 4:30 to 7 a.m. NBC 6 South Florida is everywhere.
As a kid, I wanted to play football to make me stronger. At Dolphins Academy, I saw my skills grow. Campmates turned into teammates. Summer days in shorts turned into Sundays in pads.
I'm Olivier Vernon, and we are stronger together.
Join us at Dolphins.com.
Welcome back to Generation X Youth Sports Network right here on NBC 6 South Florida. Of course, brought to you by U18 Sports Medicine. And guys, you can look over our shoulders. The skyline's a little different. Yes, it's dark because Kim and I, we're about this football life. We had to really see what's going on behind us. Now we're back to the show.
That's right, Jane. Let's get right back into that Heisman Trophy Watch action. Let's start with the mini men, the 7U's. You cannot say 7U without mentioning Elijah Just Chill Hardy. Now, there is nothing mini or chill about the way this kid plays. He's bringing the heat on both sides of the rock.
Absolutely. And speaking of a player on the high caliber, let's go to the 8-and-unders, Mr. Vincent Shivers over from the Miramar Wolverines. Explosive, exciting, all the E's right here on Generation Next.
There you go. And of course, you know, it's difficult for me to pick just one, so I've got a couple at the 9U level. Lemmy Falk representing for the Miami Garden Ravens. And of course, Andrew Johnson, who we saw earlier in the game, beasting for the Overtown Tornadoes. Both of these kids unstoppable in 2014.
The action would not stop there. You talk about going over to the 10 and under. Teron Tiger Dickens, he is the most popular guy over there at the Swag Boys. Miramar Wolverines, once yep. again, guys, doesn't matter what league this play kids and what he plays in. It could be Pop Warner. It could be AYFL. Hey, he is just really balling on that next
That's
level.
Right, Jay. Now, we see a lot of the same names week in and week out. These are just a few of them. We'll continue to break down all the different pounds, all the different players. But at the end of the day, the most important thing is you get your vote on MyGenNext.com.
Absolutely. Now, it will not be a popularity contest. It's just not the voting, and we appreciate the mm-hmm. voting. You got to get it done on the football field, Kim.
That's right, Jonah. We've got a huge matchup going down in Pop Warner. Talk about getting it done. Two-time defending national champ Coach Robert Jones taking the undefeated Liberty City Warrior Killer Bees into the Northwest Falcons nest.
Would they survive? You'll find out right here on Generation X. Let's jump right into the action.
145-pound action with playoff ramifications on the line. Falcons go into the air first, and it's Jaden Richardson coming down with a beautiful catch on the Liberty City Warriors. Back to the air again, going to the other side of the field. Again, great catch, and it's the Liberty City Warriors then coming up with a beautiful interception. Davari Foster, great job plucking the ball out of the air, getting the ball back for his Liberty City Warriors. Then Eddie Williams with the beautiful snag over the Falcons DB. Liberty City looking like they're rolling. Warriors offense on the warpath, looking to keep it going against the Falcons. But it's the Falcons picking it off. Great job, Northwest Boys and Girls Club Falcons, clawing tooth and nail with the Warriors. But right back the other way, Travis Pittman looking like the hero of the day, taking the pick to the house. But bum bum bum, flag on the play negates the whole thing. And unfortunately for both teams, great battle, but it would end up a 0-0 tie. What a great game out of Pop Warner.
tie score between the Warriors and the Falcons. I can't say I'm in love with that 0-0 action, but that's the rules.
Well, guess what? The rules are the rules, but you'll be happy to know, Jonah, when it comes to the Super Bowl, there are no ties in Pop Warner, the Super Bowl being the Sean Taylor Classic, named after, of course, the late, great Sean Taylor, Miami Pop Warner, UM and NFL alum.
Absolutely. Now, speaking of some NFL action, these kids will future be in the NFL, hopefully. Mm-hmm. Over in the AYFL, everyone is fighting for a playoff berth.
That's right. Sunrise Gators taking on the Miramar Wolverines. 125s. Let's get right to the gridiron. It's Generation Next.
Hope you didn't forget about the AYFL. Great 125-pound action coming out of the AYFL. Miramar Wolverines taking on the Sunrise Gators. And the Wolverines have been having a good season, but it's the Sunrise Gators thinking upset, wanting a little playoff action of their own, and it's the Gators defense swarming. Then it's on offense, and it's Steven Terveas taking the handoff, picking up 26 yards before he's tackled by a Wolverine. Wide receiver screen now. Wolverines aren't ready for it, but the Gators are. They're gonna take it yard. They were already up 18-6 when this thing started, since we jumped into this thing previously engaged. But the Miramar Wolverines are not gonna get blanked. They're gonna take this kick return back. At the end of the day, however, the Sunrise Gators coming out of nowhere and picking up a fantastic 30-6 victory that should help them in their playoff positioning. Great game out of the Sunrise Gators, your 30-6 winners.
Well, Jay, looks like the Sunrise Gators keep on rolling with another win over the Miramar Wolverines.
Let's check out the winning circle with the MVP. Congratulations once again over to the Sunrise Gators, winning big on Generation X. Not the only team winning. There's a lot of teams fighting for the number one spot in their respective standings in each league, Kim.
That's right. And of course, what everybody waits for each and every week right here on Generation X, the game of the week. If you go away, don't take too long, because we'll be right back.
Jaden having a heart transplant before his second birthday, it was a really rough journey. Thanks to all the wonderful doctors at Joe DiMaggio Children's Hospital, Jaden can now celebrate many birthdays for years to come.
I had surgery to correct my scoliosis at the Joe DiMaggio Children's Hospital, and now my life has changed forever. They were able to help me feel like myself again.
Welcome back to Generation Next Youth Sports Network right here on NBC 6 South Florida, being brought to you by our family over at U18 Sports Medicine. Now check it out, Jenna. We've been to the AYFL. We've been to Pop Warner. We've been all over the place. Miami Extreme, but now it's time for the game of the week.
Yes.
We've got another FYFL epic battle going down. The Fort Lauderdale Hurricane 11 Youth taking on the Miami Garden Vikings. Oh boy, this is about to be a good one.
Absolutely. This is where everyone circled on their calendar before this game was even played. Now I got to tell you, Mr. Heisman Watch himself on the 11U, Amari Daniels, leads the Vikings. They call him the one-man show.
And of course, the Fort Lauderdale Hurricanes are led by number zero, Jamari Jaffard. They call him Agent Zero. We've got number three, Dave Williams, a.k.a. Disco Dave. These boys are in beast mode.
This should be one for the ages. Let's jump right into the action.
Hope you got your popcorn ready, Gen Xers. Game of the week. The moment you've all been waiting for. Fort Lauderdale Hurricanes taking on the Miami Gardens Vikings in some 11 and under action. And it's the Fort Lauderdale Hurricanes going to the air first, but it's the Miami Gardens Vikings D finding themselves in perfect position to pick it off and get the ball into the hands of Amari Daniels. Daniels running like a full-grown man, as it wouldn't take but 2 to 3 or 4 tackles to get him down. He was running with that much power, that much speed and grace. Look at him here, taking on 3 tacklers and still coming up with some positive yardage. Fort Lauderdale Hurricanes defense, however, bends, doesn't break. Their offense can't get a first down, however, so it's right back to the man beast. Amari Daniels doing work, pinballing, look at him, off of defenders. Try to get me down, that's what he's telling everybody, and nobody's succeeding at it thus far. Fort Lauderdale Hurricanes, though, figure out a way to 4 and out them yet again. then they're coming back at it on offense. Unfortunately for both teams' offenses, both teams' defenses are two of the highest in the FYFL, and before it was said and done, it would be 0-0 at halftime.
The Generation X Halftime Report brought to you by U18 Sports Medicine. It's going down 0-0 at the half. Defensive battle.
Always.
This is what we expected in the Florida Youth Football League.
For sure. Now, of course, on the side of the Fort Lauderdale Hurricanes, they've got to get back to the basics. This is going to come down to coaching. The offense goes through Dave Williams, a.k.a. Disco Dave. I think the coaches need to slow it down and give the ball back to the guy who makes his offense happen.
Well, you know what? Talking about a guy who always gets the ball, I'm looking on the sidelines now. I'm seeing number five, who we always talk about, Amari Daniels, being the workhorse for this team. Right now, he's playing both sides of the football, linebacker, running back, special teams, doing it all. This kid needs a break, and then he can get some production back on that football field for the Scott Lake Vikings.
Well, hey, Jonah, I don't want to talk about it anymore. Let's get into the second half. Again, Vikings, Hurricanes, let's go.
Second half now, and they must have given out Butterfingers with the oranges and Gatorades at halftime, because there is going to be four consecutive fumbles on each offensive series here. Eventually, the Fort Lauderdale Hurricane defense is going to make a stellar play. They're going to make Amari Daniels cough up the rock, and the Fort Lauderdale Hurricanes get the ball right there. Now on offense, it's Jamari Geffrard getting the rock and doing what he does best with it, picking up 11 there. Fort Lauderdale Hurricanes going to the air now, finding some success, but the Miami Gardens Vikings shut it down. They go back to Amari Daniels, who's gonna break a tackle and follow some blocking right here to pick up another 32 yards on the day. He's taking it house, baby. Nobody's stopping him. They were on the board first. It was 6-0. Fort Lauderdale Hurricanes offense now, trying to get it back together, trying to get something going. And boy, do they ever. Using one of my favorite plays in the world, Jamari Geffrard connecting to Dave Williams on the double pass. Hurricanes down to the one. Then they punch it in. Dave Williams, touchdown. It was 6-6, which left the huge extra point, and the Hurricanes convert it, and they're gonna win the game 7-6. What a thriller out of the FYFL. 7-6, your winners.
Congratulations once again to the Fort Lauderdale Hurricanes, doing it big. The double pass came out. What was that, Kim? Was that a U sign?
Yes, it was.
It's the only time she can throw it up here is when those Hurricanes are doing it right here on Generation X. But if they didn't catch it right here on NBC 6 South Florida, Kim, where can they catch the action?
You already know MyGenX.com is always where it's at. You can even get your vote on for those Youth Heisman Trophy candidates. And, of course, Instagram, Twitter, Facebook, at Generation X.
And, guys, you got to make sure you prevent getting those hot donuts right here on Generation X. But, of course, my Jonah Woullard, this is Kimberly Bell, and on behalf of the entire Generation X team, you know you've been rated G.